Here we have Kitty playing with Kimchi. Which VR1D camera is this? ZKM K2 Pro, Canon R5 with dual fisheye, FM Duo, or Insta360 Evo? The answer is FM Duo. Get it wrong? Continue and try again. Now, watch this one. Which VR1D camera is this? This is Canon R5 with the new RF dual fisheye. How about some high ISO low light close up VR180? This is the ISO 3200. What do you think this is? This is again the Canon R5 with the new RF dual fisheye.
Hello there! Welcome to my video-based metaverse. Today, we are going to compare the Canon RF 5.2mm f2.8 dual fisheye with the Canon R5 to the FM Duo, a professional level 12K VR180 camera, and the ZKM K2 Pro in a controlled environment. If you are a follower of this channel, you know I like to do side-by-side comparison to show you or then tell you the result. And I challenge you comment below to tell me which one you think has the best image quality inside a VR headset like the HTC Vive Flow right here or the Oculus Quest 2 right there. Your opinion matters a lot to this community and help others just like you to make the right choice in VR180 filmmaking. Before you put on your VR headset, don't forget to give this video a like to support me to do more VR video review just like this. Now, put on your VR headset and see you in the metaverse.
Before we go into the in-depth comparison test, I want to show you some raw footage from a VR180 music video I'm working on with Ivy Hawkins. Canon R5 with the new RF dual fisheye is the only VR180 camera solution that allows me to challenge the creative limitation currently set to the VR180 cinematic setup. The Canon setup is splash-proof and water-sealed, but both K2 Pro or the FM Duo are not. So if you really want to go into nature to create content instead of studio-controlled environment, I don't see any other options out there besides the Canon R5 or the R5C with the dual fisheye lens. This music video will be released soon on my Oculus TV channel. Go check it out! Guess which camera is this? Wow, this is shot on the Canon RF 5.2mm f2.8L dual fisheye lens with the Canon R5. All footage is calibrated and stitched inside Adobe Premiere using the official paid version of the Canon plugin, which is only $4.99 a month with 90 days of free trial. The color look flat is because it is shot on C-Log 3 to maintain the dynamic range. If you look on your top left, you can see more detail in the highlight. The setting of the camera are in ISO 800, 1/60 shutter speed, aperture 5.6, which I believe get the sharpest result of this lens. Shooting in C-Log 3 or C-Log does have some noise. This is a high contrast scene. Overexpose one stop will blow out the windows completely. But in general, if you want to overexpose a half stop or a full stop to minimize noise. Now Kitty picks up Kimchi to do some close up. Kimchi is practically licking the lens there. We see the 3D is still manageable thanks to the 60mm IPD distance. If you look at the edge of the lens or when Kitty walks to the edge of the lens, you do not notice any chromatic aberration. Also, the sharpness does not decrease in the edge of the lens. Without chromatic aberration, it's one of the best features of this lens for sure. Now Kitty is moving the tube light like a lightsaber. It does not generate any lens flare. This lens has really good flare resistance. Now we have a different camera. Try it again, guess which camera is this? Right, this is FM Duo, a $20,000 high-end professional VR180 camera. It can capture 8K in 60 frames per second and 12K in 30 frames per second. Right now it is captured in 12K 30 frames per second and stitch in 8K using the FM Lite software. Even though we can capture 12K super high resolution now, there's no platform that can see 12K resolution. That's very unfortunate. In the same 8K resolution, the Canon R5 result look pretty much the same image quality as an FM Duo result. If you pay close attention to the details in the distance, FM Duo does capture more details and sharper image at distant object thanks to the 12K sensor resolution. We also notice in the exact same shooting setting, which is ISO 800 f5.6 1/60 shutter speed, there's way less noise in the FM Duo. FM Duo has a chromatic aberration issue. It is not really good at flare resistant as well. When Kitty swing the lightsaber at Kimchi, you see a green flare at the top and right edge of the lens. FM Duo has a really nice sensor setup, but it is a shame that their lenses are not as good. I don't have the production version of the FM Duo just yet. We hope it can improve the lens quality in the final production version. Here we have Zcam K2 Pro. We actually capture in ProRes in this setup, so the dynamic range is also really good on the K2 Pro. Canon VR180 setup allow us to capture RAW as well, just like K2 Pro, but the overheating issue and the crazy amount of data storage required in 8K does not make sense to capture Canon RAW or Canon RAW Lite. It also wouldn't be able to stitch right now in the Canon Premiere plugins or the Canon VR utility app. I will get the Ultimo Ninja V Plus to capture ProRes RAW with the Canon R5C when it is out, so the dynamic range will be further improved here. Right now, Zcam K2 Pro actually has the highest stops of dynamic range. But K2 Pro is weaker in everything else. There's not enough resolution, blurrier image in a distant object, and higher digital noise in high ISO scenario. Zcam, which is the leader in VR industry, can really provide better support on their cinema level VR 1D camera, but they failed to do so. Canon saw the hole in the market and really replaced Zcam now in the VR 1D market. For those of you who own the K2 Pro, it is still a great camera, but for anyone who wants to get into the VR 180 market, I don't think waiting in line to get your hand on the K2 Pro is worth it. At last, we have the Instar 60 EVO, which is kinda a toy camera for VR 180 professional, but nonetheless a great camera for consumers. You see the quality breakdown quickly and understand why VR180 needs 8K quality to really stand out on YouTube or on Oculus VR. I believe Insta360 also realized that, so they stopped the support of EVO. You cannot buy the Insta360 EVO anymore. If Insta360 1R 3D mod ever comes out, it will also be this image quality. So it's not really worth it until Insta360 push the sensor size limit and build a better action VR 180 replacement. There's no news on Insta360 or Candao yet on a new VR 180 camera release, but there will be news on a consumer level VR 180 camera coming out soon in 2022. I can't tell you anything just yet, but hopefully we can see a sneak peek during CES coming up. Thank you for watching. If you missed my first real-world test of the Canon VR180 system, check the link right here. In the next video, we'll collect all your feedbacks and do an in-depth review of the Canon RF 5.2mm f2.8 dual fisheye lens. Also, I will do a step-by-step 2022 updated VR180 shooting and editing tutorials using the Canon system, including the Canon R5 and the Canon R5C with the dual fisheye lens. You'll be able to pick up this lens, follow my tutorial, and create beautiful VR180 videos to tell your story in the metaverse. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell, and I will see you next time.